Except that you have add a couple of more words or adjectives, but why? So salutations to all of you as teachers. Without getting into the nitty-gritty of it and dwelling at length what a teacher should be and ought to be, I think much has been said by Professor Pandey. We have very distinguished teachers here. Professor J.L. Gupta, who has almost spent 50 years and odd in teaching. Professor K.N. Tripathi, again, he has hit the half a century in his educational career. We have Professor R.K. Sharma, Dr. R.K. Sharma. We have the worthy deans and distinguished professors and lecturers and associate professors and so on and so forth. But you remain teachers. I'm really happy that Ajay ji could join us in spite of his indisposition. He was not well, but he has made himself present on this auspicious day to greet you all a happy Teacher's Day. So on his behalf and on behalf of Sunuji, I convey to you a very, very happy Teacher's Day. It's a twice blessed day. It's a twice blessed day. And if I may say so, it's a thrice blessed day. First thing is the great Ganesh Chaturthi. It's such a massive celebration in homes and in the areas all around, particularly in the state of Maharashtra. Great jubilations, and the festivities go on for a couple of days, and then bidding adieu to the Lord Ganesha is a very tearful send-off. So Ganesh Chaturthi is the first occasion to celebrate. Second, it happens to be the birthday of one of the greatest philosophers that India has produced, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. It happens to be his birthday. And then the government of India recognized this as Teachers' Day. What significance, what importance do the teachers hold? What place in the society they hold? It's called a noble profession. A teacher has to be, all through his life, be a learner. A teacher has to be, all his life or her life has to be a learner. A teacher has to constantly introspect. You take stock of yourself as to how much have I learned, how much knowledge have I acquired, how much knowledge have I assimilated, and how much of it have I even disseminate to the society. So teacher is a learner, an introspector, and the teacher also keeps evolving. The teacher can't be static. Teacher has to keep evolving on the basis of one's own stock taking in the process of learning. You keep introspecting. There's a whole lot of science which I can explain to you as to how our you addresses Brahma. You are the creators of knowledge. You create a wealth of knowledge. So many people have published books, and so many more will be published, and so many in many areas of research. India had made advances, and it has gone to NASA, and even the biggest experiment going on in particle physics. India is in a very big manner associated. Out of 10,000, at least 2,000 are Indian scientists. Enormous contribution. So a teacher has to be a learner all one's life. A teacher has to be an introspector. Introspection should go on. It's a regular check that has to go on as to how much have I really progressed from what I learned a couple of years ago. Does it hold relevance in today's context? It has to be contextual. You can't stay out of the context, and you can't stay out of touch also. You need to be, as one said very aptly, teaching is a performing art. Teaching is a performing art. Each time you need to perform over and improve over. Why you are addressed as Brahman? Because you are the creator of knowledge. Like he was the creator of this Srishti. He created all living and non-living beings. The Brahma is the creator. And then the Vishnu is the sustainer. How much is your retention power? How much are you able to retain that knowledge? How much you purchase that knowledge? You need to sustain. Because if you are not able to sustain the progress that you have made, you will not make any progress further. And then you should be able to dissolve, dissolution of knowledge or dissemination of knowledge. That should reach out to the last person, the last ignorant person who is not aware of a given subject. Or the knowledge had not even touched or reached him. So you are really embodiment of all these three. You are the creators of knowledge. You are the sustainers of that knowledge, the depositors of that knowledge. And you are also people who disseminate and almost dissolve into your students and the people who reach out to you. A teacher is always a giver. Is never a taker. We come out of certain slabs and this and that, increments and holidays and vacations and so on and so forth. They used to be teachers who lived very simple life, a very austere life. Austerity was the hallmark of a teacher. Simplicity was the hallmark of a teacher. Unassuming they were, but they were repositories of great knowledge. And never did they brag ever that I know this particular subject absolutely to the last. No. Still they were learners, and they stayed learners all through their life. And with all the humility, they'll approach their students. Come on. What I know, I want to give you. And that bond of love and affection between a teacher and a student is missing somewhere. When you used to get connected with each other, there used to be such a deep bond. A teacher's household was run by the students, by the pupil. Never ever a teacher or a doctor in a village or in a district headquarters even, if you talk of 25 years, 30 years down the line, you'll find a teacher's home was run more by his students. They'll arrange for everything, provision of everything, they'll make provision for everything. Guruji ke ghar mein gur nahin hai, gur pochana hai. Guruji ke ghar mein aata nahin hai, Guruji ke ghar mein ye nahin hai. Guruji ka kurta purana ho gaya hai. Woh din kahan gaye, Malguri days kahan chale gaye woh? Kahan woh sabvedanay chali gayi? Jail Gupta ji meri wajah se tanav mein rehte hain. Dr. Vaswaluni mere bare mein kya sochte hain? Aur main kehta hoon, jo aap kar rahe ho, theek kar rahe ho. मैं पूरी तरह एंडोर्स करता हूँ आपकी फिलोसफी को. मुझे कोई हिचकिचाहट नहीं है कहने में, सार्वजनिक रूप से इस बात को कन्फेस करने में. कुछ चीजें होंगी लेकिन कभी इस हद तक कभी नहीं पहुंच पाएंगी कि जिसमें हमारा माधुर्य और हमारा जो आपसी जो आदर है एक दूसरे के लिए वो कभी कम हो सके. सुझाव हो सकते हैं, सुधार हो सकता है. सुझाव आएंगे तभी तो सुधार होगा. सुझाव आने ही बंद हो जाएंगे तो मैं उससे सुधार क्या करेगा. मैं रोज दुर्गा सप्तशती करता हूँ, रोज सोचता हूँ. एक बार मैं अपनी फियर ड्राइव कर रहा था तो मैं क्या वही कर रहा था, भज गोविंदम भज गोविंदम भज गोविंदम मूढ़मते. देन ऑल ऑफ अ सडन आई एड्रेस माई सेल्फ, वेयर इज दैट गोविंदम? आई एम नॉट सीइंग हिम एनीवेयर. आई कांट फील हिम, आई कांट हैव हिम. I don't see where is Govindam. And then finally, again, resisting myself, said, all right, that Govinda may not be there, but at least the Mudamati is in view. He is physically present here. So the physical presence of an individual in a human form or a physical form, you want to see God in all his human manifestations. That's not necessary. He guides me every day. He drives my way. He is there on the steering with me. He guides my life. And that's the kind of identification, that's the kind of feel that you should have and should get conveyed to you. Bhaj Govindam, Bhaj Govindam, Bhaj Govindam, Mudamate, Isansare, Bahutustare. Phir aage hai wo punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. Ye baar baar jo hum janani ke garbh se janm lete hain, baar baar hum bimar hote hain, janam, jara, vyadhi, mrityu, char avasthaon se guzarte hain hum log. Sab kehte hain nahi, जन्म नहीं लेना है दोबारा से, पुनर्जन्म नहीं होना चाहिए, फिर मां की जठराग्नि में सोना नहीं है, मुक्त हो जाना है. मुक्ति का भाव सब में है ना. हम सब अज्ञान के तिमिर से मुक्त होने के लिए बच्चे यहां आते हैं और अभिभावकगण आपसे बहुत उम्मीद करते हैं कि आप उनको निराश नहीं करेंगे. हम जो उसी उत्साह के साथ आप लोगों के भरोसे पर उनको कहते हैं कि किसी भी अभिभावक को या संरक्षक को ये महसूस नहीं करने देंगे कि आपके बच्चे की अनदेखी की है या उसको जो ज्ञानोपार्जन यहां से होना चाहिए था वो नहीं हो पाया है. दैट विल बी द सैडेस्ट डे इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ विप्स. वे स्वामी जी ड्वेल्स इन एवरी हार्ट. ही इज द रिजर्वायर ऑफ ऑल एनर्जी, पॉजिटिव एनर्जी. Energy also can be too, it can be negative. But he radiates positive energy. He comes charging on you, your duties. He keeps reminding you. It's a very, very noble profession. It wants a sense of commitment from you. It wants human upliftment. He has a huge charter of building this nation, building the character of individuals, and finally shaping into a man, man-making, character-building, nation-building. It's a very, very mammoth task, it's a Herculean task, it's a Himalayan task, but who is going to accomplish it? It is you, the teachers, are expected to see that this nation marches forward and ahead. It should not be a stereotype institution, it should be vibrant. We should make a material change in this system of education. We should make radical changes in the standards of higher education. Just not read definitions. Please go into the deep meaning of what a higher education is all about. Is it relating to human upliftment? Is it relating to enlightenment of human beings? Is it leading them to where they can be productive and not a liability to either the parents or the nation? ऐसे में दुर्गा सप्तशती पढ़ रहा था. ओम ज्ञानिनापि चेतांसि देवी भगवती ही सा बलाद आकृष्य मोह माया प्रेषति. जो माँ है ना वो चैतन्यात्मक स्वरूप में आती है. वो उसको ज्ञान का ज्ञान से वो चैतन्य होती है. ओम ज्ञानिनापि चेतांसि देवी भगवती ही सा बलाद आकृष्य मोह माया प्रेषति. She has the power that she can drag you towards ignorance. Remember, she has the positive and the negative energy. But then it goes on to say, Daridra, Dukh, Bhay, Harni ka Tavdanya. Daridra mera dur karo. Kaisa daridra hai bhai? Agyan se grasit hai hum log. Hum daridra hai, daridra narayan hai hum. मेंटल ग्रोथ ही नहीं हुआ, हमारा मानसिक विकास ही नहीं हो रहा है, हम दरिद्रता में रह रहे हैं. हे माँ, हमारा ये जो मानसिक दरिद्र है ना, इसको दूर करो. दरिद्र दुख तो कब होगा भाई. यू सफर बिकॉज ऑफ योर मिस्टेक्स एंड देन अल्टीमेटली फाइनली यू ब्लेम योर हेड हियर. ओ बाबा दिस शुड नॉट हैव हैपेंड, आई शुड हैव सफर्ड लॉस, आई शुड हैव बीन लुक्ड आफ्टर बाय सच एंड सच पर्सन, इट वॉज देयर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एंड ऑल दैट. वी स्टार्ट ब्लेमिंग अवर हेड, वी राइट राइट यू आर बिकॉज इट्स द थिंकिंग दैट मेक्स इट सो. You start blaming others, you start blaming yourself because it comes back to you in a rebound that no, no, you are responsible for your plight. You are responsible for your plight. If you are a miserable self, it is because of you that you are a miserable self. There is the dukkha bhai. That dukkha kab aayega bhai? Whenever we don't discharge our duties sincerely, it will lead to untold miseries and pain. What gives rise to pain? The opposite of satisfaction, where you have not reached a level of satisfaction, where that's what will give you the opposite of it. It cannot give you comfort. If you haven't done your job well, and if you go home and say, today I couldn't really do justice with my job, it will lead to pain. दरिद्र दुख भय भय कहां से होगा. When you committed some sin, as the greatest sin to see that I am not discharging my duties with that sense of devotion which was required to. You always carry a sense of guilt, and that guilt makes you fear something, fear of the unknown. This will come, they'll remove me, they'll suspend me, they'll take disciplinary action, my job is not secure. This fear grips all those who don't stand and rise to the occasion and accept it and say, no, here I am going to turn challenge into an opportunity for myself. Masi prarthana hai daridra dukha vai harni ka to danya sarvopakara karnaya. I want the human welfare of all of you. दरिद्र दुख भय हारणी का तब दिन्या सर्वोपकार करमाए सदा दृचित्रा सर्वमंगल मंगल्ये शिवे सर्वासादिके शरण्ये त्र्यम्बके गौरी नारायणी नमस्तुते शरणागत दीनानाथ परित्राण प्राणे सर्वशत्रुहरे देवी नारायणी नमस्तुते सर्वस्वरूपे सर्वैसे सर्वशक्ति समन्विते भयाद्यास्त्राहिनो देवी दुर्गा देवी नमस्तुते रोगान शेषान पंचतृष्टा रुष्टा दुकामान सकलादृष्टान Tvam Shetanam Ne Pinnaram. You have to have a sense of self-surrender to the ultimate, the goddess of wealth, goddess of knowledge, and the goddess in the most ferocious form, the Mahakali, Mahasarasvati, Mahalakshmi. You have to be obeisant to them. Become spiritually enlightened people. Just reading books. I asked this question. There were few candidates who were appearing for the post of a lecturer in education in Shyam Prasad Mukherjee College. I was chairing it. I had a department of education from Delhi University and one expert, they had come, VC's nominee. And I asked this morning, Professor K.N. Tripathi was referring to Dr. Jakir Hussain. I asked simple question, was Dr. Jakir Hussain an educationist? And the reply was yes, invariably yes. Sir, do you also endorse this, that Dr. Jakir Hussain was an educationist? No, he was not an educationist, in spite of being a professor emeritus, he was not an educationist, because what he did was that he propounded and implemented Gandhiji's basic philosophy of basic education. So originator of that idea is the educationist. Gandhiji can be termed as an educationist because he comes out with an original idea. Most of the professors designated as professors are repetitionists. They have nothing fresh to add, nothing more to abstract. If you want to remain connected with the live wire, you will be the repositories of infinite knowledge. Infinite knowledge, you will have the key to infinite knowledge. And you will have an ashram to acquire that knowledge. But you need to manifest the divinity within. By controlling nature, external as well as internal, you may do it by work, worship, psychic control, by philosophy, maybe by more than one, but you have to be free from the bondages of ignorance. Lead me from the unreal to real. Lead me from darkness to light. And what the darkness is all about? Ignorance. We are all saying ignorant, and we are dispensing that ignorance also in a massive, on a huge massive platform. So please be learners always. Keep introspecting, keep evolving. And one fine day you'll find that you have qualified in teaching, which is the performing art. You perform and then you improve upon your last performance. And that's how you keep evolving. And finally, you are the best teacher. And let me tell you, these awards and rewards need not be bargained, which is being done now. For the Padma Awards, there's a particular lobbying. Even the Magsaysay Awards, there is a lobby that exists which lobbies for you for getting your Magsaysay Award. There is a lobby which is lobbying, The awards and rewards should be conferred. The honors must seek after you. It shouldn't be you who should be seeking after an honor. The honors must automatically be conferred on you. Don't think that there are no thinking human beings. At least here I can assure you that we are very observant and very thinking human beings. We think about everything. We think about your stagnation, we think about your increments, we think about everything. Maybe a few problems that we are facing at the financial front, maybe financial resources. But it will not be able to hold us for long. You will get your due, and I assure you on the Teacher's Day, we'd like to make you all very comfortable and joyful. Thank you.